competition, yes? Yes? Who's going to win? Nobody's going to win, or you're going to win. Cool. I know there's another guy here as well, so you've got the call and a girl, you've got competition. And is idol about music and dance, or anything? Anything artistic? So what happens apart from music and dancing? Is there any art? Comedy. Very good. Who's a comedian? Who does comedy? You do everything. You're already a rock star. Well, I wish you luck with it anyway. It's been very nice talking to you. Have you got any more questions before I leave? Or you have? Oh, you really have. Yeah. Okay, tell me. Tired after a concert. It's strange, you know, obviously your emotions build and build and build during a concert, and at the end you just feel totally dead. Well, that's how I feel, and the older I get, the more dead I feel. Yes, young man. Why did I want to sing? I think maybe I realized I wasn't good at anything else. So I decided to sing. Yes, ma'am. Where are my band? I would imagine they're probably sitting in the hotel room doing nothing. One thing you'll find in your life, musicians are very good at doing nothing. They're the best in the world. Okay, yes. I feel when I'm singing, I feel, I mean, when I started singing, I felt like I was floating, you know, it was like a very strange feeling, you know, you don't feel as if you're in control of yourself anymore, you know, you've, like you're almost like you're in some third dimension of your life. It's a strange feeling. Now it just feels very normal. It didn't always feel normal, is that?
Can you hear that okay? Do I think I'm doing good?
Of course. I'm always good when I'm singing. I think, you know, it's important actually, when you're a performer, confidence is a huge thing, you know? So to feel, to believe in your ability, even if you're not very good, I think is important. There are many people out there in the world who have very successful careers and they're not very good. And there are people who are very, very good who don't have successful careers. So confidence is a huge thing. Yes,
how did you meet Dennis?
How did I meet them? They telephoned me and said, invited me to London to meet them. So that's how I met. Yes.
Do you like
your
friends?
Do I like my friends?
Fans.
No. Not really. I'm joking. Yeah, I mean, you know, I think it's important now with social media playing such a big part in the music business and the entertainment business, that you have to be very aware of your fans, and it's good to have something that keeps them involved in what you're doing, especially with social media, because there are so many bands, so many artists, that it's very easy to be here today and gone tomorrow in this business. So you have to look after your friends. So that the young girl with the glasses on.
What do you do in
your
free time?
What do I do in my free time? I sit on a bus most of the time. I mean, nowadays I'm quite involved in my girlfriend's career. You know, I take an interest in this. She's a contemporary dancer, and I really I really learn a lot from contemporary dance and from the world that she lives in. You know, it's a different kind of art. It's much more cool, I think. And I learn a lot, so I like to pay attention to what she's doing because it influences my music. So, young lady with the glasses.
If there is a big stage, what would you be doing?
If there's a big stage, what?
A big stage, your biggest performance.
What is the biggest performance? 130,000 people. I couldn't see the back of the audience. And it was in Hamburg in 1999. I played to 130,000 people. So that was my biggest concert. The young man, your arm is getting tired.
Why did you start
with music? Well, I just felt it was the right thing for me, for my life. You know, I loved it when I opened my mouth and started to sing. It sounded good, so it seemed like a sensible thing to do. And also, this was very important. When I was 14, I fell in love for the first time. You know, I met my first real girlfriend, and I sang a song in a school concert called Romeo and Juliet, which was a Dire Straits song, and of course, it's a very famous play. But I sang a song called Romeo and Juliet, and she was crying in the front row. So I thought, I have power. I used it. So that's why I started. For the girlfriend. Hi, Ben.
Would you ever consider getting a dance job?
Did I ever consider what, sir?
Would you ever consider having a regular life, a dance job?
A regular life?
Yeah.
I would do everything in my power to avoid this. Yeah, it's not the kind of... I don't think it would be very easy for me now to have a boss telling me what to do. I don't think I would be good with this. So it's a good idea for you to avoid it if you can. That's my advice to you. You look like an intelligent guy. Use it. There's a guy in the back.
Can you tell us a bit about life?
Life on the road. Well, it's kind of changed, you know. When I first started traveling as a musician, and if you were going somewhere like London or Paris or Milan or whatever, you know, it was really very exciting thing to do, especially if when you arrive, you know, you're on TV in this country. And so I think life on the road, I made a decision. There's a lot of temptation, as you can imagine, in the music business, whether it's sex or drugs or rock and roll, as they say. I always avoided drugs. I never went for that, ever. I smoked cigarettes, but even that was a bad idea. But I always avoided that side of it. I felt emotionally, my emotions were too strong and too extreme, just naturally. But if I started to do drugs, then I would probably end up like Amy Winehouse or something, you know? And so I avoided it. So my life on the road, okay, I used to have a few beers, of course. And, you know, I maybe had a few girlfriends in my life. But apart from that, I've been reasonably sane. Almost. So, any more questions? Yes, my friend. Why did I come here? To see you. Why did you come here? To see me? Yes! So we're friends now. You've just made a new friend today. It's good. Okay, yes, young man. My favorite singer. Ooh. I think when I was, my first favorite singer was David Bowie. You don't know them, do you? You know them? Okay. That was my first favorite singer. Sorry? Did I see him in reality? You saw him, of course. You're much more cool than me. But I like David Bowie, so maybe you could get my autograph for me. I'll give you some money. Okay, so is a lady in the room. Sorry, I can't see one more. What do I think about Romania? Well, I haven't had much experience. My first time here was I was in Bucharest doing a music video with Armin van Buuren, a DJ, and Armin did a remix of one of my songs, and we did a music video in Bucharest a few years ago. My memory of it, I think it was minus 20 degrees, and we were doing it in the old town, you know, and it's a really cool video, I said, but, and my first thing I remember thinking was, wow, there's some beautiful girls here. I remember that. Yeah, so, and I remember going into the little bar, having whiskey, you know, because I'm Scottish, of course. And I remember it being very cold. When I came, I played a concert in Turda, a couple of years ago. And it took us, I think, 21 hours to get here on the bus. So that was quite long. And then we arrived, and I remember, I think for me, that there was a very warm people, you know, very welcoming people. And I remember that. I live in Poland now, you know, I live in Poznan for 5 years. My girlfriend's Polish. And I remember the same thing when I arrived in Poland about how there's a great sense of family spirit in the country and a warmth about the country, you know, and having grown up in the West and spent most of my time, you know, in countries like Germany and France and stuff, I felt that one thing that we've lost over the years is this warmth. We've lost this kind of family spirit that we used to have when I was young. It doesn't seem to be there anymore, maybe because we became too wealthy, we had too much money, so we didn't need people so much. We just thought that money could replace friendship and money could replace people, but of course it doesn't. And what I do like about coming to Eastern Europe, to be honest, this is a very nice warmth about the people, and I think that's missing in Western society. Yes. My first concert. It was 30 years ago. I guess you won't remember 30 years ago. Just a feeling. How old are you? You're six. Okay, so you don't remember 30 years ago. Yeah, long time ago. Long time. Yes. How much money do I have? €4.5. So not so much. I've had a lot of money in my life, and then I've had no money, and then I've had a lot of money, and then I had no money. At the moment, I'm in the middle, I think. So, it's not too bad. Of course, nowadays there is a lot of reality TV shows, and in my, you know, my life has been, I've been working for years and years and years to become a musician and to have some, a career. So when I see someone become successful in 5 minutes, I find it kind of difficult to understand. But that's life. You know? Yes. Yes, you.
Can I sing what?
A rock song. Okay. I'll finish with a rock song. This was my first big success in 20 years ago, actually, in 1994. So thank you for listening. And I'll play a rock song. This is, as I say, this was my first success. It was with my band Stilton, and it was number one in the UK and across Europe. And I made a lot of money from this. And then I spent it.
Blinded. As if you think.